Hello everyone, I haven't been able to release a video in a long time, so I wanted to come back with a great video and show you 5 different ways of achieving consistent characters in Midjourney. So the first step is pretty simple. All I have done is generated a character sheet. So I wrote character sheet design of a girl with a jetpack, various angles and poses in the style of children's books, watercolor detailed character sheet. And then I use the 16 and 9 aspect ratio for more outputs. So this is what I got, and I chose one of these images here. I like this one, so I chose to upscale the number 3, and then let's go down here. Yeah, so this is what we got. So what you can do once you have an image or once you have a character sheet that you like is that you can actually use the pan feature to go to the sides or up and down. So this simply takes this image and it just goes to one of the sides and generates more. And the beauty of it is that because of this first image, it uses it as a reference and it generates more characters like it, but in different poses. So this is exactly what we want. Let me go down and show you some of the results that we got. So I've generated a bunch of different character sheets. So this is the first one here. As you see, so the first 5 to the left are our initial image and the ones on the right are the new generations. So as you see here, it is a new pose, and once you do that you get 4 images just like you normally would, and you can choose one of them. So that means we get 4 new poses just by panning to one side. So I chose to upscale this image here with this extra output, and now we can just choose to pan to another side. We can just repeat the same process. Here I've chosen to pan to left, so this image, and then we got this, and as you can see we got a new pose here to the left. Alright, let's move on, and if I go down here, I'll show you how it looks like if you pan down. So this is the images that we got. So this is what it will look like if you pan down a 16 by 9 aspect ratio image. So this is our 5 first poses, and when we pan down, we got this here. The same goes for this here, and this here. You get an extra 5 set of poses beneath your original image. And the same thing goes if you choose to pan up. So this is our image. Now above it is the new set of images. So some of them might look weird, but this is actually a really good way to generate some extra poses or use some extra elements in different angles for your stories or whatever it is you're creating with this. So if we go back to our first image, another thing that we can do is use the zoom out feature. If we click on zoom out 2x, starting from this character sheet, we'll see what we get down here. And then let's do the same thing but use the 1.5x zoom out. So I usually recommend you to use the zoom out 2x feature, and you'll see why. And this is what we got. So if we zoom out 2x, we see that we get new poses of our character because of the zoomed out feature, and it's because it's using the same character sheet here and it's just zooming out, so it's creating new poses of the same character. That's why they look similar without using any character reference. So this is actually a really good trick, and you can also re-roll or generate multiple results until you get something that you like. And down here is the one where we zoomed out 1.5. so as you see, it doesn't generate, like, I prefer this ones here because you have better images or better quality. But down here we only get like 1 or 2 extra characters, but they're like the same size as our original ones. So for me personally, I like this ones here much better than this ones. That's why I always try to zoom out 2x. And yeah, here's the re-rolled one. So as you see, we get some extra new generations. So these ones here are pretty crazy, but this is all right. This is all right. So moving on to the next method, this is one of my best ways to generate consistent characters, and this is what I like about Midjourney. This method is by using the character reference feature. This is a new feature that hasn't been around for a long time. All you have to do is you crop out the heads of your character, and then you just upload them separately. And now you can just click on right click and click on copy link, and now you can use it as a reference to generate new characters. So here I have written a girl reaching to take an apple from a tree, and then I've used the CREF, which stands for character reference, and then I have just uploaded the heads of our character separately. Yeah, and this is the images that we got here. So the styles are a bit different, but if we use the style reference as well, and we input the same images as the character reference, we get something like this, and this is actually closer to our style. So yeah, this is a great method of generating new poses with the same character. So let me show you how I work with this here. Let's say I'll go with this one here. I want to use this head for my character as well, because it has a bit more details in it instead of this here. The last method is a pretty simple one. So I have just generated two set of images. The prompt is a girl meditating beneath an orange tent in the style of children's book watercolor. So let's say we want this one here. We like this one. We can just upscale it. And then we're going to use the vary region feature, which is the inpainting of Midjourney. So inpainting means that you can regenerate some parts of the image. So let's just click on this one here, and we can just select with the lasso tool like this, or if you want, you can just pick this one here and make a square or rectangular, whatever you want. And then we can just say a girl and then CREF, and inside of the vary region feature or the inpainting, we can refer to our character and use the images of their head. So I have just copied and pasted the heads. And the reason why we can just say a girl is because we have already generated the entire image and we're just focusing on the head. So a girl and using the CREF feature should be enough to generate the image that we want. And this is the three images that it will use as reference, as you saw quickly. So while it's generating, let's just try another one. So I would probably go with this one, but let's just take this one because this girl has blonde hair and it might seem harder, but it actually isn't. So let's just see. So yeah, exactly. So after generating, this is the images that we got. And again, we can always use one of the more detailed faces that we generated earlier. So if I go up here, we can just pick this one. And another thing is that she has her eyes open, and we can just use the same method. Click on the vary region, select this part here, and just write closed eyes, eyes closed, or whatever you want. So you generate something like that. Another method would be if, let's say, we can go with this one here, the number 4th. So let's go and pick this one. Let me show you something quickly inside of Photoshop. Let's go and open you up in Photoshop like this. So what I can do is just pick this here and this here, and just write remove eyes. There we go. So by writing remove eyes, we get something like this, and we can pick the one that we like. So this looks good, this looks good. There you go. So here I just use the generative fill, which is inside of Photoshop. If you have Photoshop, you can use the generative fill, which uses AI. I really recommend you to learn Photoshop. I know there is Canva out there, but Photoshop really gives you that extra control and you can do whatever you want with it. If you have followed my channel, you know that I use Photoshop most of the time, and maybe at the end of my process, I use Canva to create the PDF or to put everything together into a story or a book or whatever. But I highly recommend you using Photoshop and learning Photoshop. Here I create two illustrations, starting by replacing the head of our character. I use the liquify tool to widen the neck and generate some background scenes of a futuristic Zen garden for our illustrations. Next, I want to add a meditating monk and generate character sheets for that. I find one that I like and I remove the white outlines inside of Photoshop so that it matches our style. I duplicate our meditating monk and change the color of their clothes and hairband to blue and red. Next up is adding shadows. I flip a copy of our character vertically and can turn it into a shadow by changing its color and adding some blur. I add the outer glow effect to our meditating monks and create one in blue and one in red. I write this text here to grab your attention and use the zoom blur effect to really make you subscribe to this channel. For the second illustration, I chose another background and use generative fill to expand our image. Next, I chose this angle of our character facing away and create a copy of the plants on the bottom part of our image. Now we can put our character beneath it. Let's add our monk again, now in another angle. We add a shadow beneath him, and now let's just change the color of the hairband to red and add the last touches. Lastly, I changed the brightness and contrast of our main character to blend it with the rest of the image. I finished it off by adding a few speech bubbles to our illustrations. You don't need more than that to create a short and fun story. It's all about being creative. There you go. I really hope you liked this video and make sure you subscribe. Thank you so much. Bye.